Today, Trump and Bolsonaro met in Washington to discuss a wide range of topics, mainly economic ones. The meeting was very fruitful, with Trump promising to make Brazil a major non-NATO ally and maybe even a NATO ally. Bolsonaro, meanwhile, underlined their common values. Brazil and the United States are tied by the guarantee of liberty, respect for the traditional family, the fear of God, our creator, against gender identity, political correctness, and fake news. Prior to the meeting, some tensions between the US and Brazil existed because of Brazil's active trade with China, which the US has started a trade war with. Brazil's economy minister, Paulo Guedes, stated that it will not reduce its trade with China and instead invited the US to trade more with them. Trump welcomed that idea, stating that Brazil makes great product and we make great product, and our trade has been never as good as it should be in the past, and in some cases it should be far, far more. Furthermore, the US has signaled openness to support the entry of Brazil in the OECD if Brazil gives up some of its rights in the WTO. Malicious tongues might claim that Trump and Bolsonaro get along together so well because they are birds of a feather and because Trump likes everybody who satisfies his own vanity. And there's probably some truth to that, or a lot of truth, but also there are some more important economic matters in the background. As a side note, do you remember when NATO was an alliance against the USSR and, you know, was between Europe and the US? Neither do I, but apparently our history books claim that once it was that way. Nobody knows exactly what NATO is actually doing now. Apparently it's ensuring that the energy supply of the world. What? Nowadays it seems like the only criterion to get into NATO is more that you're just a right winger that is liked by the current US president.